part two of our HBCU video. If you haven't seen part one, I'm gonna put it up here. But make sure y'all go check it out so that you can already see some of the stuff we talked about. But now we're gonna answer some of the questions that you guys asked me on Instagram. And some of these are just directly for certain schools, so we won't all be like answering all of these questions. So, well, I guess we all can answer this. Somebody said, how is the dating life at HBCUs?
Ooh, I'm gonna start. Sorry, that was I feel like for the AUC, the dating life is kind of I feel like you know everybody. So your business is always out there, and we do have a lot of people from Atlanta. So it's like, oh, like I know that person, or it's like whoever you talk to is gonna always be like somebody like in your business. So yeah. That's what I would say.
I think the same for Howard for that aspect. Like, it's a lot of people, but the community is small. Like, everybody knows what's going on.
I kind of want to say, well, first, don't come in college looking for a relationship. That's kind of what I want to say. Yeah. Because, first of all, you're in a new environment. Like, you need to get there and get acclimated before, like, you're trying to find somebody to date. Like, I feel like a lot of people had this thing where they're like, ooh, black love, you know, yeah, I'm about to
find okay, I'm gonna say something. Black love, I feel like you don't find that till like your junior, senior
year.
And everybody as a freshman, we are maturing mentally, physically, like we don't know what we're trying to do with our lives. So I feel as if, I mean, it's kind of inevitable to like find to say I don't want to date, because I mean, I'm pretty sure all of us are talking to somebody, but
just don't be so like strong and like I'm going to find my husband first year, because that's usually not what happens. Like it definitely can,
It's cool. It's cool to like date or whatever. Like but just don't be like, oh, I want to be my boyfriend. Oh, da, da, da. Like just chill out.
And also, y'all just remember like, if it's meant to be, a lot of times these gonna be the same people who dare your junior year. So you know, y'all supposed to be here. Y'all gonna be.
If it's meant to be, it's gonna happen. Everything happens for a reason.
What y'all think for NCAT dating life?
It's like, I don't even know how to.
I'll say the same thing. Like everybody know each other.
You think?
Yeah.
Simba.
Like social media and Twitter and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so now they want to know, why did we choose our HBCU over other HBCUs?
I chose Howard because it's Howard.
It's the Mecca.
Yeah.
Maybe.
And it was the best place for what I wanted to do, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And then I also, like, I wanted to go for the all-around experience. So I feel like I can get a good education multiple places. But part of why I really went was for the experience. And also, like, the opportunities that I would have in my career field once I graduated. That's more so why I chose.
Yeah. For me, my battle was in between Spelman and Howard. And first of all, the number one, like, decision maker was because Howard gave me more money than Spelman did. Also, I didn't want to stay in Atlanta. Also, I don't think Spelman has either it's a film school or a theater school. They don't have it. Which one?
We have theater and we have documentary filmmaking, but I don't think we have, like,
film and television.
Yeah, we don't have that.
Yeah, so, and that's what I wanted to do. So, I mean, I could have taken classes at Clark, but why would I go to another school if this is my school? So, that was another one of my, like, reasons why I didn't choose to go to Spelman. I think that was pretty
also, good. I had toured Howard so much, I was really comfortable there. So that was also part of it. Like, I think it's important that y'all, like, tour school. So, I had been so many times, so I really knew that I felt comfortable there. And that's where I wanted to be, because I was torn between there and Morehouse, but, like, I didn't want to stay here either.
Also, y'all, I feel like when I toured Howard, I feel like two or three times before I actually went, anytime I stepped on campus, I felt like this is where I'm supposed to be. Even though, like, in my other videos, I talk about, like, how I wasn't adjusting well, I feel like that's God. Like, I'm going to be stronger when I leave there. Like, this is where I'm supposed to be, and I'm going to be a whole different person when I leave. Yeah. So I definitely know, like, that's just where I'm supposed to be.
You know, I went to NCAT because it was good for my major, and I wanted to go to HBCU. Yeah. So, yeah.
I went to NCAT because, like, the area, North Carolina, I got in-state tuition because that's where my mom's at. And I have a lot of alumni in my family that went to NCAT. So, like, when I went on tour, like, they like, persuaded me to go there. And it's, like, the number one HBCU, so.
Whoa, sorry, that is really bad.
Like, you keep saying that. You keep saying that like it's right.
Man, we're not going to get into it. Like, we're not going to get into it.
Sorry, it slipped.
Now to the number one HBCU for 13 consecutive years. Yeah, okay. So, I'm sorry. I had to do that because you
I don't think that's accurate.
Okay, do your research, sweetie.
Look it up.
I will. After this video, we're going to do it. Okay. I chose
number one HBCU in the nation.
It's Spelman.
Tell me what pops up.
It's Spelman.
But that's why we can't get ready to go.
Okay. Okay. I chose Spelman not just because it's a great school, but because my mom went there. That's a really bad, like, reason. But my mom went there, so I will always, like, be exposed to, like, Spell House, everything about Spelman, like, with just the HBCU or whatever. So, it was kind of like, I mean, I had a choice, but not really. And I just love, every time I went there, it was just like, you know, when you go to school, you're like, oh, this is where I belong. Yeah. That's how I felt when I walked on the Spelman's campus. Yeah, so just the environment, the magic that they bring, yeah, I just love it.
Also, I went to Howard for the prestige. Like, it's one of the top HBCUs. That was a big thing for me. Like, not just going. I wanted to go to HBCU, but if I went to one, it was going to be one of the best ones.
Okay, this question is more so for me and Rashan, but I definitely wanted to address this. They said, is Howard really worth the hype?
That's a
good one. So, I definitely feel like it is. And I also feel like I can answer this question better after being there for 4 years.
Me too.
But as far as being there now, I see why people love the school as much as they do. Like, a lot of the events that we have, like, you can really see, like, the family aspect of it. Like, I know, the other day when they screened 21 Bridges with Chadwick Boseman, we were in there and people was just up and dancing and stuff. Like, and I feel like it's small stuff like that. Like, there's someone in our cafeteria, every time we go in, she is, like, greets us in the most sweetest way. And I feel like it's the small things that make people fall in love with their school. But I definitely feel like our school is worth the hype.
I agree.
I feel like in areas where you're expecting it to be, I'm gonna tell y'all, like, when I was coming to Howard, like, I'm thinking, like, it's gonna be lit every day, like, school jumping, party here, party there, and that's not necessarily the case. But I feel like in the areas where you feel that it isn't hype, no one's listening to me.
I mean, they're listening.
You're right.
Sorry.
And the areas where it fails to, like, live up to the hype, it makes up for it in the small areas, like Zakia said.
They were asking, was 21 Bridges good? And it was good, y'all. Make sure y'all check that out.
I want to see that.
That movie is real good.
I didn't go see none of the screenings.
Okay, they said, oh, I know I saw a question in here. Okay, I don't want to do all of these. But I know I saw a question in here. It said, how is the brother-sister relationship, or how does it work at Spelman?
Well, like for NSO, you get your Morehouse brother, and everybody's assigned one. Immediately from there, you can have a good relationship with your Morehouse brother. You can't. It's just either or. I got me and my Morehouse brother are really cool, but he was in stroll, so most of his, like, first semester was devoted to that. So I didn't really get to hang out with him. But, like, me and him have a really cool relationship. So I'm glad that happened. People can adopt Morehouse brothers. If you don't like your other Morehouse brother, you can adopt them. But, like, the relationship between Spelman and Morehouse, it's like really brother sister. Like, it's literally right there. Spelman's right here, Morehouse right there, and we basically do everything together. Take classes there, eat there, study there. They come over to Spelman and study. So it's really just, it's one big institution. Yeah, I would say.
Okay, so Natalie asks, what are the benefits of an HBCU? I can go first because I know they're thinking, but y'all, I am a strong advocate for HBCUs. I feel like all Black kids should experience an HBCU if they can. Mm-hmm. And I strongly believe this because I know before I went to Howard, I went to a high school and it was mostly Black people there. It was. But the material that we learned was not strongly dedicated to Black people, like Black history. So I say this in a lot of my videos, but literally in every single class that I have, they always find a way to connect it back to Black people mm-hmm. and Black history. And that's one thing that I strongly do love about it. And I also love the fact that the people I've competed against, they are Black, but they also, like, you know, people say we won't be prepared for the real world. That's what a lot of people argue. They argue that, and they argue mm-hmm. diversity. Mm-hmm. But what I know is that I have to work 10 times harder because I will never get something because of the color of my skin. Like, you know, sometimes when you go out for things in the real world, they have to have one Black person in there to make their yeah. business look good. But what I know is that anything that I get, I will get because I actually work hard for it and I was actually qualified for the position. So that's another thing that I definitely love about it. Or why, I, like, a benefit of HBCU.
I love, like, the HBCU family. Mm-hmm. Like, when somebody say, oh, I went here, I went there. It don't even got to be the same institution. But it could just be like, oh, wow, you went there. And just, like, the events that go on and how when you're at, when you have pageants or you have the fashion show, you just have different things. Just people just get up and start dancing, just make it a big old party. It's just, or you have like Fried Chicken Wednesday. It's just like things that you just, things that you just like remember. Like, I don't think you get that at a PWI. I mean, they try yeah. with the little Black student unions and no, like going to HBCU, yeah. you're going to get the real experience. And I love how, do y'all have like a class? Like, you just learn about, like
Afro.
Yeah. yeah. We have our, if you're interested in Spelman, every freshman's gonna take, African Diaspora in the World. And in that class, we learn, like, things we didn't know about ourselves, like, past things we did not know about ourselves. And I just really love that class. So I feel like going to HBCU is really gonna help you dive deeper into yourself and to know, like, why, like, we deserve to have, like, have respect. Period. So, yeah.
I think it makes you appreciate being Black more, too. Mm-hmm. Like, it's just, because people think, like, it's Black people are Black people, but it's all types of Black people. Like, people yeah. from the West Indies, yeah. Africa, everywhere.
Side note, I'm from everywhere. Oh, and people come from everywhere, and you cannot say that it's not diverse. Like, if you come up there, you're going to see people are from all over the country, all over the world. So.
And people think only Black people go there, and that's not
no,
true.
That's, we like, have,
my
like,
mentor,
two white
my mentor is Asian.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We have two hey, white Asians. People.
Oh, yeah, it's a lot of white people mm-hmm. showing up, like.
We have
yeah.
people. And, ooh,
what are y'all think your benefits?
I would say, people say we're not going to be ready for the world, the real world. Yeah. But in this video, like, we all go to, like, the top HBCUs. So, with, like, internships, like, Spelman yeah. will, like, every day I get internship opportunities, yeah. just anything with just going out into the real world. We yeah. all know what that means, but the real world and just finding job opportunities and branding and networking yourselves. We have career fairs all the time. We have like medical schools always coming. So it's not like they're not going to know like who you are. So, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Another thing I can appreciate is I feel that Howard or HBCUs in general, I think they give you a lot of good hands-on experience.
Yeah.
Like, I know at Howard, like, with the hospital, like, students, the medical students, yeah. like, get to go at to the SOB. Hospital, mm-hmm. SOB as well. And then, like, the School of Education, like, there's literally there's a middle school on campus, and there's, like, a whole daycare, like, early learning center. So it's, like, they really get that hands-on experience to yeah. prepare you before you go into your field. Oh, communication. We have a television station. We have a radio station. So it's, like, you really get to get your feet wet before you actually leave campus.
I agree with Kennedy on that, or like the family aspect and the networking part, because like going to A&T, it's a good engineering school, so like it's easy to get internships there. And like for family wise, it's like everybody, it's like one big family. Like if you need help with something, somebody's gonna help you if you just ask.
And going what all of them said, like the family thing, you're gonna make connections like being Black and going to HBCU, because like going to HBCU, they all, like, no matter what HBCU you go to, like, we're all family, and we all have, like, that pride, because we want to all, like, really emphasize that we're, like, mm-hmm. you know.
And, like, BET had did, like, a special on, like, I don't know if it was, like, a special, but it was, like, something towards, like, Spellhouse Homecoming, and it was, like, they were interviewing this guy, and he was talking about how he can call up, like, 15 lawyers right now if he needs somebody. He can call up, like, a astrophysicist. It was, like, he was, like, I could call up anybody I need right now, like, any big-time person, and they were graduates of Morehouse. So that's pretty big to me, too.
Okay, so we're just going to do a few more questions. This question said, do you ever get tired of black people?
Okay, I was asking when you said that to me. I was like, yeah, okay.
No.
I don't even
think that's a dumb question. I'm sorry.
I won't get tired of black people.
Yeah.
No.
What
no.
do they mean? I think they didn't mean
next
that.
Question.
No.
Okay, okay. Next question. What was our favorite memory? I love our favorite memory this semester.
Jiho.
Jiho.
Boy.
Jiho, Jiho, Jiho.
Hey.
I'm telling bro, it's worth the hype. Like.
Mine was y'all, mine was I really think mine was okay, during freshman week we went to a pajama party. That was really fun.
Oh,
also, I really loved when Chadwick Boseman came for 21 Bridges. Like, it was just so inspirational. Like, it was like, after we watched this movie, he sat down and talked, him and the other producer. And I just felt like it was just so amazing. And I don't know, y'all, that was another one. And lastly, Howard, there's a park by Howard called Banneker.
Oh, Banneker, yeah.
Y'all, we had a little party. Like, that it was during homecoming, and I guess a lot of the parties got shut down. So everybody texted me, like, everybody meet at Banneker, meet at Banneker, meet at Banneker.
So
everybody came to Banneker. They had got a DJ. It was just so much fun. That was so much fun. So that was another one of mine.
For me, I had two.
Ooh, you hungry? Hey, don't care. I was like,
oh, like, hopefully nobody hear this.
I'm too hungry, bro.
Okay. Oh my God, you and JJ.
No.
Oh.
Y'all don't understand how good this JJ is. What's the other day?
I had JJ's.
Okay, for me, I have two experiences because it's so much that happened to me in my semester, my first semester. But I would say the first one is being involved in being a cheerleader and just meeting so many like great girls, just having so many sisters I can call on now. And the second one was the Miss Freshman pageant. Yes, that's it.
All right, y'all, so this is the last question, and the question is it easy to get into the school that we got into? So I can start off and say that Howard, one thing I can say is that Howard has a holistic review, and I think all of these schools do, but basically that means that they will look at your test scores, your community service, your essays, your recommendations, all of that, and then decide whether you can be accepted or not.
Mm-hmm.
But I would not say that it's easy. I feel like it's not easy to get into no school, really. But basically, y'all, honestly, if you have, like, a C or, because I saw a question in here about having a C on their transcript from sophomore year, what I want to say is that colleges like to see improvement.
Mm-hmm.
So try to improve your grade. If you cannot, if you're a senior or a junior and you really, like, time is up, try to make sure you go hard on the essays. You always have control over your essay. Make it really personal. Try to get really good recommendation letters. Definitely do that. And also, I would recommend for extracurricular, seek leadership roles, you guys. Do not just be a part of numerous things. Like, try to be the president, the vice president, the secretary. And always make it clear what your role was in whatever you did, so that they can see that leadership and, you know, the responsibility and things like that can come out.
For NCAT, I think it's pretty easy to get in. Of course, you got to meet the grade requirements, but it's not like...
It's not a walk in the park.
It's not... You said it is or is
it's not.
Yeah, it's not, but it's easy.
Yeah.
Like, if you're doing what you need to do, and, like, you're doing what she said, like,
you'll get in.
You'll get in for sure.
With Spelman, it's not easy getting Spelman. It's not easy because you don't know, like, what they're looking for, because Spelman does do holistic reviews, but, I know some people who didn't get in, and they had, this is a personal experience, okay? My mom actually, because the valedictorian at her school did not get in, but my mom got in over her. I know several people who I was in group chats with who had, like, 4.0 GPAs. Their SATs were perfect, but not perfect, but really good, and they did not get into Spelman. Spelman really catered. I would say Spelman really loves community service. And if you're looking into going to Spelman, make sure you do an essay on community service or something and talk about how like community service is like important to you. I was, I got into Spelman with below the minimum SAT, ACT, but my GPA was so high and I was so involved in everything, and I had leadership roles at my high school. So Spelman was like, okay, well, we can still work with her because she has all this other great stuff and just one thing that's like, you know, because everybody isn't good test takers, so don't let that like discourage you. But I would say Spelman is pretty tough to get into, and yeah, Spelman is very tough to get into. But if you're doing what you need to do, then you can have faith into getting into the school.
I don't think it's, easy to get into Howard, but I feel like similar to what they said. Well, honestly, you really don't know. Similar to Kennedy's situation, like, it's people who you thought would have got in, they didn't get in.
Yeah.
So I feel like they're looking for the best student possible, how you can benefit, what you can bring to the campus.
Mm-hmm.
So that goes back to her saying that she was involved. Like, although the test score wasn't there, she's clearly had the ambition and she was involved, all of that stuff. She could come and better the campus.
Yeah.
So I think that's the biggest thing. Just show the school why you should be there, how you're a well-rounded student.
Yeah. So honestly, y'all, do not feel bad if you feel like you did not score as high on the test score, if you feel like your grades are not as good. Just make sure that you really put a lot of effort and energy into the other sections of the application. Also, make sure that you are not waiting till last minute, y'all. That is a big part of this. Make sure you have somebody read over your essays. Make sure that you're asking the right people for recommendation letters. Like, there are small things you can do in the beginning to really, like, help the outcome be what you want it to be. But
something else, I would say, like, build connections. Yeah. If you're, like, really strong about a school, like, have connections so people can really vouch for you. So, like, I was really involved with the alumni chapter for Howard here in Atlanta. Mm-hmm. So, like, the people know me. Like, I was in their programs. So, I was like, if you're sure about a school, like, make those connections that you need to make.
Yeah, my mentor was at Spelman at the time when I was, like, applying.
Yeah.
So, like, she really helped me with everything, with getting in. Shout out to Morgan.
Definitely. So honestly, y'all, do not feel deterred.
Deterred. That was kind of funny.
Y'all,
I'm
just trying to close the video.
Not Morgan's.
I'm just trying to get back in. I'm trying to close the video. Again, y'all, so just do not feel discouraged if you feel like you did not do as well. And if you are a senior and you are applying in January, you guys, I just want to wish y'all good luck.
Best of luck.
Y'all still have time, you know, to get your applications and things ready during this break. If y'all have any questions, I'm going to put all of our social media and things down below. So feel free to reach out to us because we can talk to you on a more personal level. But that basically concludes this video. Thank you guys for watching.
Thank
Make sure you
watching.
Like, comment, and subscribe. And hit that bell button so that my post notifications come on. And I will be back with more videos.
Hey,
you know?
Dang it.